With his return to New York, President-elect Donald Trump faces a pressing need to set more of the foundation blocks of his presidency in place by filling vacancies for Secretary of State and other top posts. Distraction looms, however, much of it created by the president-elect himself, whose extraordinary claims widespread voter fraud during a 12-hour Twitter offensive on Sunday cast a shadow over the legitimacy of an election that he actually won. Quote, "I won the popular vote if you deduct the millions of people who voted illegally." Trump tweeted in the afternoon before alleging an evening tweet, "Serious voter fraud in Virginia, New Hampshire, and California." Trump's transition team did not respond to questions seeking evidence of the claims. The charges come amid a recount of the presidential votes in up to three battleground states, an effort joined by Hillary Clinton despite decidedly tamped down expectations that the election's outcome will not change.
President-elect Donald Trump plans to continue meet with the potential political appointees Monday as he and his transition team fill out his future staff. Trump is scheduled to see Milwaukee County Sheriff David A. Clark, Jr., who has been mentioned as a possible pick to lead the Department of Homeland Security. Clark, who ran as a Democrat, served as a Trump surrogate during the campaign while working on his transition in South Florida. Trump named the two appointees Friday, Don McGahn as White House counsel and Kathleen Troia, Casey McFarland as the Deputy National Security Advisor.
A nine-story portrait of a young Fidel Castro has joined the towering images of fallen guerrillas overlooking Havana's Plaza of the Revolution, the massive square where Cuba on Monday begins bidding farewell to the man who ruled the island for half a century. After 10 years of leadership by Castro's younger brother, Raul, Cuba finds itself riveted once again by the words and images of the leader who dominated the lives of generations. The fiery revolutionary turned dictator who controlled the communist island for more than five decades and railed against America's capitalist ideas died Friday at age 90. The mourning period for Castro ends with a final mass and ceremony on December 4th.
The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers says it has no plans for forcible removal of protesters who have been protesting the Dakota Access Oil Pipeline. The Corps said in statement Sunday that it is seeking a peaceful and orderly transition to a safer location. The Corps notified tribal leaders Friday that all federal lands north of the Cannonball River will be closed to public access December 5th for safety concerns. The agency says those who choose to stay do so, they're at their own risk. The Corps say anyone on the property north of the Cannonball River after the date will be trespassing and subject to prosecution. The land will be closed and includes the main protest camp about 50 miles south of Bismarck.
A top Donald Trump advisor warned Sunday that the president-elect's supporters would feel betrayed if he tapped former Massachusetts Governor Mitt Romney as Secretary of State, a move that would put a once fierce Trump critic in a powerful cabinet post. The comments from Kellyanne Conway depend a highly unusual push by some Trump allies to stop the president-elect from nominating Romney. The extraordinary public nature of the effort has also stirred speculation that it could be Trump-approved attempt to humiliate a prominent Republican who staunchly opposed him throughout the presidential campaign. Conway's opposition to Romney's is also supported by Steve Bannon, the controversial conservative media executive who will serve as Trump's White House senior advisor.
Cyber Monday may be in danger of losing its online sales title. The Monday after Thanksgiving is traditionally the busiest online shopping day of the year. But stores are releasing internet deals earlier, stretching them throughout the week, as well as making them available on apps and in stores. Shoppers looking for discounts spurred online sales on Black Friday to a new high. During the holiday shopping, the weekend that kicked off on Thanksgiving and the day afterwards, known as Black Friday, more and more shoppers have decided to skip the mayhem in stores and buy online. Consumers spent $3.34 billion shopping online on Friday at 21.6% increase from the same day last year, according to Adobe Digital Insights, which tracks online retail transactions.
Disney's South Pacific animated The Tale Moana dominated the Thanksgiving box office over the long weekend. The war reviewed Moana about a princess's mythical journey in the ancient Polynesia, boosted by the star power of Dwayne Johnson and the appeal of original songs from Lin-Manuel Miranda of Hamilton. Landed at Disney an estimated $81.1 million. Following the second was J.K. Rowling's Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, which earned $65.8 million, and the Brad Pitt-Marion Cotillard World War II romance Allied opened with a mediocre $18 million. Warren Beatty's first film in 15 years, the 1950s Hollywood comedy Rules Don't Apply, bombed with $2.2 million, and while Bad Santa 2 didn't flop as badly, it still only pulled in $9 million over the Thanksgiving weekend.
Interview with the vampire novelist Anne Rice is working on her next work of art, the TV adaptation of The Vampire Chronicles, in a Facebook post that the best-selling author said that she had regained theatrical rights to the series of novels and redefined the vampire genre in the 1970s and 80s, and is now beginning work on proposed television series adaptation. The Vampire Chronicles are a hugely popular series of novels revolving around Lestat, a functional French nobleman turned into a vampire in the 18th century.
The Kansas City Chiefs and Denver Broncos added another stupendous chapter to their AFC West Arc rivalry. In the last seconds of overtime in an evenly fought defensively punishing grudge match, Chiefs kicker Cairo Santos kicked a 34-yard field goal that banked hard off the left upright but behind the other, winning the game 30-27. The game nearly ended in the fourth quarter with the Broncos up 24-16, but Chiefs quarterback Alex Smith marched his team 75 yards to a touchdown and two-point conversion to tie with the game at 24 with 12 seconds left. Smith finished 220 yards passing and a touchdown, while rookie Tyreek became the first Chief with one rushing, one receiving, and one kick returning touchdown in the game, in the same game since the great Gale Sayers accomplished in defeat in 1965.
As Tom Brady led the New England Patriots to a 22-17 victory over the New York Jets, he also added his name to the top of the NFL record books. Brady's 200th win tied him with Peyton Manning for most wins by a quarterback in NFL history. Despite an allying knee, Brady finished the day with a 286-yard passing with two touchdowns, with both scores going to Malcolm Mitchell. "We didn't play as well as we wanted to," Brady said, "but we made the plays when we needed to." The Patriots also set a new mark in the team history books, becoming the first original AFL team to rack up 500 total franchise wins.
Joe Flacco connected with the Breshad Perriman for a first quarter TD as the Ravens outlasted the Bengals 19-14. The Saints torched the Rams 49-21 as Drew Brees passed the 210 yards and four TDs. Devontae Freeman barreled through the line with 60 yards and two touchdowns as the Falcons chewed the Cardinals 38-19. Ryan Tannehill connects for those three touchdowns to nose the Dolphins ahead of the 49ers 31-24. The Bills Buffaloes and their way over the Jaguars 28-21 behind stampeding LeSean McCoy's 103 yards and two touchdowns. Marcus Mariota notches two second quarter TDs to lift the Titans over the Bears 27-21. Eli Manning tosses three touchdowns as the Giants pan the winless Browns yet another loss, 27-13. The Chargers zapped the Texans 21-13 with Phillip Rivers 242 yards passing and three scores. The Buccaneers stunned the Seahawks 14-5, holding Russell Wilson to just 151 yards. And the surprising Raiders improved to 9-2 on the season with a 35-32 win over the Panthers, remaining tied with the Patriots for best record in the AFC.
High, 39 points to cover the Cavaliers' slow win over the 76ers, 112-108. The Nuggets stopped the Suns 120-114, with Eric Bledsoe leading all the scorers with 35. DeMarcus Cousins puts on a 37-point 11 rebound clinic to the left Kings over the Nets, 122-105. The Bucks beat the Magic 104-96. Miles Turner and Glenn Robinson, they each scored 17 to lead the Pacers over the Clippers. 91-70. Despite Anthony Davis' 38 points, the Pelicans lose to the Mavericks 81-91. James Harden scored 38 big points for the Rockets, 130-114, win over the Blazers, and the Lakers lap up the Hawks 109-94.
Dominic Moore, David Bax, and Jimmy Hayes all score in the second period to help the Bruins bash the Lightning 4-1. Jamie McGinn slaps in the tiebreaker for the Coyotes 2-1 win over the Oilers. The Jets blank the Predators 3-0 behind goalie Connor Hellebuyck's huge 40 saves. A trio of goals in the second period is all the Canes needed to top the Panthers 3-2. The Senators shut out the Rangers 2-0, powered by Craig Anderson's 33 saves on goal. And the Flyers elevate over the Flames 5-2.
Alabama stays the lone undefeated atop the rankings with a 30-12 win over 13th-ranked Auburn. The so-called game for the ages went to second-ranked Ohio State, who narrowly defeated number 3 Michigan 30-27. In two overtimes, fourth-ranked Clemson routed South Carolina 56-7. Number 6 Wisconsin withstood an early challenge from Minnesota to win 31-17. Seventh-ranked Penn State muddied the Big Ten waters with a 45-12 win over the Michigan State. And number 9, Colorado won the Pac-12 South by beating 22nd-ranked Utah 27-22.
Seattle Sounders FC advanced to ML's Cup final by defeating Colorado Rapids 3-1 on aggregate the total score over both match legs. Sounders will face the winner of the Eastern Conference Leg 2 final between Toronto FC and Montreal Impact on Wednesday, the 30th of November.
That's all we have for you today. I'm Carl.
And I'm Kyle.
Join us again tomorrow for the daily news. Bulldog TV is an affiliate of the USA News Network.